A move that I love to use is the truck. You know, I love trucking people. It just feels like it's way more powerful than just having double hooks behind, give me your back, and just trying to go for it. You know, this is too boring for me. Just trying to go here because it's so predictable. Guys know how to defend that. But once you get guys in the truck, you know, there's multiple ways to attack from here. There's so many different ways. You know, you can, of course, you know, twister and right here, cross ripper. You know, you can go cast slicer, all the basic stuff. So my thing was, I'm trying to figure out ways to get into a truck, as many as possible, right? So any way you can get into a truck, or any way you can get into the back is a way you can get into a truck, right? Just always remember that. Just one hook, that's all. It's easier for me. So the way I want to teach you guys to get in a truck right off the bat is going to be, it's like a combo. I look at my moves like combos. I mix moves up together, so this is just the 100% to the truck, right? If you don't know the 100% is like a neck crank. You know, you control the guy's neck. So we're gonna start it with the guy being super tight, keeping good pressure. All I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna stiff arm him the way he's looking. So if he's looking towards his, whatever way he's looking, if he's looking towards my left, I'm just gonna push him towards my left. If he's looking towards my right, I'm gonna push him towards my right with my right arm. Same arm, same way. All right, so I'm using my left arm, I'm pushing him. Now as he comes back, I'm gonna snake this hand around and I'm gonna catch this gable grip right underneath. This is called 100% right here. It's a crank. If I want to, I can just crank them up right here. But a lot of guys are beasts and they ain't going to tap out. You know, they don't care about cranks. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use this crank as a sweep. All right? I'm going to bring both of my feet on the mat so I can use my hips. I'm going to hip up into him and I'm going to roll him over to my right. Boom. Instead of going all the way to the mount, I'm just going to step into the half. Now the most important part is this, the transition to your knee, to my right knee and my right elbow. I'm still holding this crank, keeping this head trapped underneath my armpit. So what I want to do, I want to elevate my body onto my right elbow and bring my right knee to the mat. Keep that arm there, Richie. If the guy keeps his arm there, you just crank him. That doesn't feel good. So you're cranking him this whole time. I'm bringing my right knee up. Now he's going to be smart and thread that arm underneath my belly or through my belly across. Now my balance point is my right knee and my right elbow. I never let go of this grip. I'm nice and tight right here. Alright, now I'm gonna sit him up. Right here, boom. Alright, I'm still controlling him. I got this trap and I got his leg trap. Now, if you guys know the truck, you see it already. You know, all I gotta do right here, this is the most important part. As I go to my back, I'm gonna tuck my elbow in and I'm just gonna pull him into me. Right into a truck. Alright, the way we're gonna control a truck today, we're gonna go with the cleat control. We're gonna hold the toes. Bring this arm underneath, and we're gonna thread it through. As I window wipe around, I'm gonna catch that with my armpit. Boom. This is the best way to control the truck. All right, one more time. So remember guys, the combo is 100% to the truck. All right, this is one of my favorite combos. You can get the head so many different ways. Anytime I come up, boom, and I just grab the head, I can already go 100%. Boom. Bridge up, roll them over, all one flow. Push him away. As he pushes back, we keep this arm underneath cable grip. Nice and relaxed. Alright, controlling him. I have control of his upper body. Now, I'm going to use my hips to help me roll him over. Boom. Once I roll him over, I got to stay tight and I got to catch that leg in half guard. Now, this part is hard for people to use their head and their elbow and their knee to come up. See, I bring my knee to the mat and my elbow. Now, lifting him up, keeping the strength. He threads that arm through. Boom. He thinks he's free. Traditionally, guys might take their back, but I'm going to go for the truck. So I'm going to sit him up. Alright, this is easy for a lot of guys, but a lot of guys mess up. They go here. They go here and then they go to their back. They try to pull him over and it's just too much weight, especially if you're a smaller guy. I don't want to have this guy's body weight on top of me. Alright? So I want to sit up. I want to bring my knee very as high as possible, past his shoulder. Now I'm going to sit him up, sitting on my butt, alright? Now I'm going to pull him back, but I want to let go eventually for his back to hit the mat. So as I pull him back, I can let go. I'm just going to cross my ankles, nice and tight, pinch. If he's like that,
I don't really care. I can just keep this here. But eventually I want to catch this. You don't have to, though. Sometimes you might be having that leg curled up. And, you know, we can go here if you want to. Yeah, but we, right now, I just want to get it with the control. It's one hook over. All right, this one's right on top. You can go here, finger four. And slowly pinch your knees and creep up and catch this hook into the lockdown. Boom. I'm going to thread this arm underneath. Window wipe around. Control. I'm going to get finished here if I want to. One time. So relax. Remember, when you're drilling, you just want to be relaxed. You don't have to rush anything. Just go slow. Don't miss a step. Go slow. Come on. High on your head, shoulder, elbow. Well, he thinks he's free, but I just got him into my truck. This is important right here, guys. This is the most important part right here. I just gotta just truck him right here. It's really hard. I gotta really pull him over me, all the way to my left.
Now he, I can let go and stay here. And keep up.
Grab that arm, rainbow around. Catch that leg underneath your armpit. Just hug it. It's very tight if you're not flexible. Some guys are flexible, some guys are not. You might not be able to finish here all the time, but I established control. If he's going crazy, then I know I can control him here for a little bit. And I can just relax. I'm not in danger. He's in danger. He's playing defense now and I'm attacking. Alright? There's not much he can do to me here. Maybe if I'm lazy, maybe catch his arm and try to actually armbar that way. If I'm sloppy, I want to keep this arm tight, elbow tight. All right, one more time. So remember, guys, this combo's of two moves that I learned. I learned 100% to take the back. And I was like, all right, well, if you can take the back, obviously you can get the truck, right? So I got the 100%. I rolled him over, stepped into half guard, and I just pulled him into my truck. So it's the 100% to the truck. Remember that, right? Come back.
Sometimes he might be sitting back on his heels, like I said, and I could fake a hip up, come up here, and just catch it. Boom. I got it 100%. Alright, I'm not gonna try to get stuck here and try to finish here all day. I'm just gonna go for a sweep and get a better position from here. So I'm gonna bring both of my feet on the mat, I'm gonna bump them with my hips, and I'm gonna roll them over to my right. Boom. Step into half guard, roll to your shoulder head. And look at my forearm right here.
Okay. Now he brought that arm through. Go ahead, bring that arm back, Richie. A lot of guys are going to be here, and you can't set up a truck here. So you got to let the guy come through. And the guy, he can't be arrogant and just stay there. He needs to come through or else his neck's going to hit or hurt. So once he throws that arm through, I can set him up. Boom. Now this is the part I want to pull him back.
He's in the truck. Faster.
Any questions? Best way to learn, in my eyes, in my opinion, is by drilling. I mean, I can sit here and talk and explain a million details in it, but it's not going to make you guys any better. I'd rather see you guys doing it and then correct you guys what was not working for you guys, okay? So we're going to come around helping you guys out. Let's get some reps. Ready?